And now, the Crypt Keeper of Creepy, the provocative Prince of the Tweens, the Nightmare from Neptune, it's Zabujard!
Hey guys, just wanted to talk about some things real quick. little update. I've been applying. Oh, I got sick as a dog, by the way, 5 days ago. I don't know how. I think at the mall or something. I got sick as a dog. I'm sick as a dog right now. I feel like a lot of people in my life have thought I'm a liar. My friend Jan did. And my sister did. She thought I was giving away a gift card. Maybe my mom does too. I don't know. But I do think I genuinely try to be a good, honest person. It does piss me off that. But it doesn't matter. Anyways. What did I want to talk about? Oh, I'm sick. I'm sick right now. I really hope I get better soon. I've been praying. I've been praying at night to get better. To Hashem, which is the Jewish name for God. Okay, so Hashem means the name, because God is everything, so he's infinity names. So instead of just trying to call him all the billions of names of God, you just call him Hashem, which... And there's another word that's special in Kabbalah called Yod-Heh-Vod-Heh, or Hebrew, and that has every letter in the Hebrew alphabet in it, I think. Or maybe that's Hashem, I don't remember. One of those two, I think. So it encapsulates all the alphabet, all the language, all the letters into the name of God. So you're calling God by the name that is all names, you know, you're calling him, like, because he's infinity, right? He's like everything. He's every name. He's every single thing, right? And so you're calling him Hashem because that is the name of, that just means the name. So instead of trying to call him a billion different names, you just call him one name, which is Hashem. Anyways, and it's different because, because people I used to pray to, I don't know, like, you're supposed to pray to the Father, right? But then a lot of Christians pray to Jesus Christ, who they think is the Father, and yet also the Son and the Holy Spirit, all three in one, kind of, but separate. Jewish Kabbalism, they take the Holy Trinity and they multiply it by four. Because in the Tree of Life in Kabbalah, there's ten or 11 Sephiroth, and God has a quality in each of those Sephiroth. The God who rules over this world the most, maybe, or who created this world, is Elohim, which is in Gevura, of judgment, rebukement, that aspect of God that was created from Ein Sof, the infinite light that came into Kether and then moved down into Abba and Ima, or Bina and Hokmah, I think. and the mother Bina created this world and created Elohim, so that evil could exist, kind of, while the father aspect of the Lord was distracted or something. So this world was created possibly by a female god aspect version of Bina. And what Kabbalah tries to do is fix the world. And that also includes teaching every woman Torah. Because I think the Zohar says when every woman knows the Torah, then the world will be, like, fixed. So it's very important. If you are a woman, oh, my fucking nose is so stuffed up, dude. It's very important if you are a woman right now, or a girl, whatever, or if you know a girl or woman, like your mom or whoever, it's very important maybe that you teach them the Torah, because it says when every woman knows the Torah, then the world will be fixed. We're trying to bring back to give the mother Torah, which is Bina, the woman. We're trying to fix her, and we're trying to give her to the Torah. So if you know a woman, try to introduce them to Torah, I think, because that's what it says. Okay, that's what it says. And other things to consider. Don't eat pig meat, because that's not kosher. Don't eat bottom feeders such as lobster or shrimp or pig. God commands us not to eat pig or shrimp or lobster, because they're bottom feeders and they eat the crap off the ground. They eat crap. And so technically you're kind of like eating crap when you eat a crap eating animal. You understand? You know what I mean? So consider cutting out ham, shrimp, and lobster. And also, God said not to drink milk and eat cow beef in the same hour. So if you're going to have a cheeseburger, you can't do that, because the cheese is dairy, and then the burger is cow. Hamburgers are fine, but you're not supposed to have dairy and cow meat in the same hour. Maybe put the cheese, maybe eat the hamburger and then eat a slice of cheese after an hour. Where am I going with this? What else is new? I've been applying to a billion jobs. I'm not getting any. I'm not getting any callbacks. And I'm almost totally out of money, and I have to pay the rent very soon. What day is today? Probably like 3 weeks or 4 weeks. It's like 3.5 weeks. I need to pay rent again, and I might barely have enough to pay rent in 3 weeks. But after that, I have nothing. I have nothing after 3 weeks. In 3 weeks, I will have nothing. So I really need to get a job right now so I can pay the rent, because in 3 weeks, I'll have nothing. I'll have no money at all. Zero. $0. 0 cents. 0 shekels. 0 kegels. Nothing. I'll have nothing in 3 weeks. Nothing. Now, as you guys know, I've been talking about the eclipse ending the world on April 8th. So we will see if that happens. That's coming up soon. You might want to prepare if you feel led to do that. I would if I were you, but that's just me. But of course, if it doesn't end the world in 3 weeks, then I need a job like right now-ish. Like right now. Because I need to start working to get money like right now. And I've applied to several jobs. I don't know how many. 4 or 8 jobs, something like that. And I got like nothing back, pretty much. Like nothing. Not good. If you guys have ideas on money or jobs, write them in the comments. That's fine. I will read them. The cartoons don't pay the bills. I wish they did, but they don't. Nobody watches my cartoons, except for a fucking handful of you. Nobody watches them. Nobody donates. Nobody likes my cartoons. A few of people like my cartoons, maybe. Write in the comments if you like my cartoons. Write in the comments if you like them. But needless to say, they're not making money. They don't make money. So they don't make much money. They don't make very much money. You know, my rent is $600 a month, plus like 50 more in gay utilities. Sorry, I don't want to complain. Okay, in Hebrew you say, Nekam Adonai. Okay, vengeance is the Lord's, vengeance is thine. Nekam Adonai. You say Baruch Hashem, which means blessed be He. He's God. Okay, so it's all in Hashem's hands. It's not a problem. I shouldn't be complaining. The thing is, guys, we people here, God's people, godly people, holy people, we are exiled from this place, because this place is evil, rotten, wicked, gay, retarded, dumb, and we're fad bullshit world. So yes, we will always be somewhat miserable, depressed, repressed, repulsed, exiled. We will have a hard life here. This world is an evil world. It's created out of evil. It's created for evil. That's just how it is at this disgusting fag world. But, but it's fine. It's fine. You just gotta keep moving forward. You just gotta pray, and Hashem is with us. He's in everything. He's in you. He's in me. Everywhere. He's connecting us right now. You know, it's gonna be okay. It's gonna be fine. And even if I can't pay the rent, I don't know what I'm gonna do. I guess I would be in my car living in a Walmart parking lot, or at the library eating Clif Bars every day and drinking drinks. I'm kind of a sugar addict. A lot of people have a no-sugar diet. I kind of have an all-sugar diet. Everything I eat is made of candy cane sugar. It's not good, or is it? I do like to go against the norm and rebel against things. So when people tell me not to eat sugar, I want to stuff my fucking ass in their fucking face, and I want to eat sugar. You know, if people are telling me what to do, I don't like being told what to do. I've always loved the idea of freedom. Not being told what to do. People tell me what to do, I get suspicious, I get grumpy, I get frisky, I get feisty, I get spicy, I get annoyed. I say, who are you to tell me what to do? You idiot, retard, fuck. Who are you to tell me what to do? You know, I like to do what I want to do. You know, I want to do stuff. I want people say, you can't be in your room doing art all the time. You gotta get a job. Shut up. Just watch me. Just watch me. Normies are so angry and pissed that my last job I worked 2 days a week. You know? My sister is a normie. She was pissed. She wouldn't let me hang out with her. She said, you can't hang out with me until you work more than 2 or 3 days a week. You need to work way more than that. Shut up. You don't know what you're talking about. Normies are just gay, retarded idiots who are obsessed with work. I want to work 1 day a week. Suck on my fucking balls right now. Suck on them hard. Because I'm only going to work 1 day a week for the rest of my life if I have the option to. If I have the option to, that's what I'm going to do. And I'm going to budget my money. I don't want to work more than 1 day a week. Oh, Jerry, you can't work 1 day a week. Watch me. Learn how to budget. Learn how to budget. For me. Sorry, I'm getting grumpy. I haven't done a podcast in a while, so I got a lot on my mind, a lot on my tongue, okay? Just cut me some slack. Just cut me some slack. One of the best parts of my day every day is taking a shower. That's it. That's all I need is a soda and a shower, and I'm good. I would like to stay in the shower all day if I could. And I think sodas really help my mental state. It really helped me a lot. I know that might sound crazy to a lot of you guys. And yes, I'm drinking sugar-free sodas, so don't worry about me, I'll be fine. I'm drinking sugar-free sodas, and I find that I'm a very simple man. I want a shower and a soda, okay? I'm a simple boy. Just relax, get off my case. Why are people on my case? All I want to be is left alone. Leave me alone with a mini fridge stocked full of sodas and some sort of bathtub. And that's, I'm good. I don't need anything, so I'm fine. Oh, and maybe a Wi-Fi connection and a computer or something, or I don't know, maybe a tablet or something to watch anime on. I don't know. Hell, maybe a notebook with a pack of crayons so I can draw stuff or something, you know? It'd be nice to draw stuff, too. You know? This world is boring, gay, and retarded idiot world. You and me will continuously be bored for the rest of our lives, a lot of the time, because you and me aren't studying Torah as much as we should, or Zohar as much as we should, or Kabbalah as much as we should. We're not studying God's Word, the first five books of Moses, at least as much as we should. The Torah Old Testament is the five books of Moses. All the other books after that in the Old Testament are written by the prophets about those five books of Moses. And synagogues you go to, they only have the five books of Moses. Those are direct quotations given from God to Moses on Mount Sinai, I think it is. I don't know. Is that the right one? Mount Sinai. Written word for word, letter for letter. It's extremely important because God chose each specific word and how they're spelled in each specific letter, because it all means something. It's all perfect the way it is, and it proves everything you need to know about anything in this world. And that's why you're bored all the time, is because you're not studying Torah and Zohar enough, and neither am I. And that's why I get bored too. It's literally why I get bored as well. I'm dead serious. And, you know, Jesus Christ came along, and the tricky thing about Christ is that the Christian Bibles, a lot of Christians don't read the Old Testament books, which I think are in the new Christian Bibles, but they kind of gloss over them because they're not written about Jesus. Christians read their New Testament books and they skip past the five books of Moses, which are word for word from God. How can it be any more important than that? I'm going to skip over these five books. And where do they go to? Boom. They go to the apostles writing about Jesus Christ. Jesus is awesome. Jesus is cool. Well, Jesus said this, Jesus said that. Hey, wait a second. What about those five books that God directly told us in the beginning of those New Testament Bibles? No. Let's skip past that. Let's go right to the Jesus stuff. Let's pray to Jesus. Talk about Jesus. Think about Jesus. Whoa. What about Moses? What about God directly spoke to him? Let's read what God said directly. No, that's okay. Let's read what the Father said directly. No, that's okay. That's okay. Actually, I just want to read about the Jesus stuff.
Sit closer together.
So some people think that Jesus kind of, in that way, took people's Torah away from them, because now they're not interested in those five books of Moses. Now they're interested in the Jesus books. But those five books of Moses are probably the most important books in the universe, because those were directly given to from God to Moses on the mountain. You know, and I think that's why they're really important. And people are like, who cares? I mean, that's like what the majority of Jewish people study, and they study the literal. Unfortunately, they study probably mostly only the literal interpretations of those books, and not the deeper Zohar stuff about them, or the Kabbalah stuff. But at least they're studying those, I guess, whereas Christians are like, I'm more interested in the Jesus stuff. I don't care about the five books of Moses given from the God Father directly. I don't really care about that. I'm more interested in the Jesus stuff. You know, so that's kind of an issue. It's a little bit of an issue. The New Testament books were written in Greek. Of course, the Old Testament was written in Hebrew, which is important because God spoke in Hebrew, and he created the five books of Moses in Hebrew. So why are the New Testament books in Greek? Because God didn't speak Greek to Moses. So did God speak Greek to the apostles and Jesus Christ? Interesting. If that's true, interesting. The point is, Hebrew is God's language. If you're watching this video, start learning Hebrew. Just memorize the alphabet. Just do it. You'll thank me later. Just do it. It's a really easy alphabet to learn and memorize. It's exactly like the English alphabet. So similar. So easy to learn. Super duper easy to learn. Just learn it. Just do it. It's so easy. A gay fat caveman can do it with his balls tucked in between his legs, tucking underwear at Target. They sell tucking swimsuits and underwear to kids at Target. That's awesome. I think that's awesome. Yeah, sure, Target got boycotted, and Bud Light and Budweiser did for having the spokesman who was a tucker. Sure. But they still did it. I think that's awesome. If you like Target, and I shop at Target all the time, by the way, and I support that they sold tucking trans underwear to kids and swimsuits to trans to kids. So let me get this straight. These kids, these youngsters, they need this tucking underwear swimsuits? So why would you sell a young boy a tucking swimsuit? Doesn't that seem a little groomish to most people at Target? Well, it's because they're trying to... These wicked evil ones, who I can only name by their cult, which is Heir of Roth. Look that up. Sabadian Frankist Heir of Roth. J-E space 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 W-S. Okay, look that up. Heir of Roth. Look up what that is. Look at me. So they believe committing as much sin as possible and as much evil as possible will bring the Messiah into the world faster, probably. But they're also just as evil and wicked as it gets. And they claim to be J-E-W-S's, and yet they're the most evil, wicked people on the entire planet. You know, the Torah says, do not sin, okay? So any person with a particular nose who is sinning right now is not a real one. They're not real. They're fake. They're not real. And yes, I've seen a whole bunch of memes and a whole bunch of schemes. You know, am I skeptical of, let's say, a gaseous sort of room that happened 70 years ago? Of course I am. It seemed like all a big fairy tale. A gaseous locked room from 70 years ago. Very skeptical of a big gay fake event with big gay fake chimneys where the smoke comes out. Oh, of course it's gay and fake. It was used to create a fake nation of ISR, EL, and you know, those people are exiled. They don't need a nation. They don't need one. They shouldn't want one. They shouldn't be in one, want one, or need one. We are God's people in this world, and will always be chastised and casted out, because you have holy God in you, and evil people will always push to screw with you and push you around and call you a cuck fuck and a cuck sucking tuck fuck and a Target shopping motherfuck and a shit. And I shouldn't even be cursing, because that's a sin as well. I don't remember what says that, but I know it says that maybe Proverbs or Psalms, since the tongue is very, there's a lot of power. Anyways, so there you go. I just sinned just now because I was fucking cursing. God dang it. It's really hard. It's really hard. Anyways, so that's all I wanted to talk about. Sorry if this is kind of a... I know a lot of you European people aren't very religious, but consider trying it out. Australians, Europeans, Africans, Asians, whoever, wherever you're watching this from. Most of my audience is the United States, Canada, or New Mexico. Okay. I miss you and your family. Talk to you guys next time. Bye. Thanks for watching. I got a new cartoon coming out today. Please make sure you watch it. Please. Bye, guys. It's about Drake and Josh. You'll like it a lot. Bye.
Now it's time to have a snuggle with my very best friend in the whole wide world. You. Well, I'm glad you could come over. See you soon. Bye. Thank you. clown jumped over the moon.